Hello, and welcome back to the Maya Hand Modeling Tutorial. In this episode, we're going to add bones to our skin. What bones do is allow the skin to bend and twist to follow the path that the skeletal bones underneath take. Just like the bones on your own skin, if you move the bones in your hand, the skin that's on top of it is going to follow along and move exactly the same places where the bones go. So let's get started. Let's start by moving this mesh into a position that's a little bit easier to access. I'm going to press the W key there and bring that up. And we're just going to put this in a nice central position. Just a nice standard easy to access position in the middle of the mesh right there. That looks good. And we're now going to go to Freeze Transforms, Modify, Freeze Transforms. And if you look at the channel box, when we do the freeze transforms, what that did is it took the transforms and replaced them with zeros and ones. Now that data didn't go anywhere, Maya still remembers it, but that has been hidden from you, the user, and instead it's given you this nice clean box with zeros and ones to work with. That's often a lot easier to use than if it was filled up with all those floating point values. So our skin is now centered on the grid. Now let's put some bones in it. So we're going to go back into front view over here and bring that down. And we're going to go over to the animation shelf and we're going to click on the joint tool. And now we're going to start adding bones to our mesh. We're going to start down here, create the first joint, which is the root joint, come up here into the wrist. Then come a little bit over here into the middle of the hand, and maybe up into this knuckle over here, and then up to the first finger joint, then to the second finger joint, and then finally the very top of the hand. I'm going to press enter, and that's going to be our first no snaking hand joint there. So let's add some more bones. Let's click on that again, and we're going to start at the middle of the hand, and come up to this knuckle this time, and then up to that first finger joint, second finger joint, and finally the tip of the finger there. I'm going to press enter. And there we have the first two finger joints. They're kind of shaky. We're going to edit that a little bit later. And let's just finish up by adding more bones. Now, the bottom of your thumb actually has a bone right here. It's not so obvious because it's kind of hidden in your hand, but it's very important because that is what allows your thumb to bend forward. So we're going to put a joint there, and another one here at the root of the thumb joint, another one right about there, another one at the tip of the finger, and we're going to finish off by going the other way, on the other side of the hand for the baby finger. Start at the wrist, one down here for the base of the hand, up here for the knuckle of the baby finger, and a joint there, and finally one up there. I'm going to press enter, and this is a good starting skeleton, a good mesh for our hand. Now you notice that some of these bones snake a little bit. So what we're going to do is we're going to zoom in and we're going to position them a little bit more precisely. I'm going to press the W key, so when we click on there, we're in translate mode. Now we don't want to translate the joint itself because if we do that, everything underneath it moves too. And that's usually not what we want. So I'm going to press Control Z to go back the way we were before. I'm going to press the Insert key. And now what we're moving is not the bone, but the pivot of the bone. And when we move the pivot, only the center bit moves. And this is a lot closer to what we want, because we don't want the entire, all the children to be moving. We just want the joint, joint we're focusing on to move. So while insert mode is still on, we're going to just adjust this, make sure everything is nice and in the middle there. And right there. Okay, and you can fiddle with this until you have something that you're happy with. I think that looks pretty good. Okay. Alright, now another thing that we are going to have to do is add some extra geometry to the skin here, because when the fingers actually bend, we want to make sure there are enough polygons. Right now there is only one break here, so when that finger starts to bend, it's going to have very little geometry to bend with. So let's select the mesh, and let's go back to our polygons, and select the Insert Edge Loop tool, and click there. And we're just adding a few extra polygon loops here, so that when our fingers do start to bend, they have that much more room to bend in. And that should be good. I'm going to go back into the main mode here, and you can see we just had just a couple of more creases right around the joints there. Okay. And now, let's see. Now, another thing we're going to have to do... Actually, let me make a save file first. Okay, is adjust these local coordinate axes. Now, it might not be obvious at first why this is useful, but it's going to be very important later on. So, let me select up there, and I'm going to all objects off. I'm just making it impossible to select things I don't want to select right now, so I turn all those off, I can't select anything. I'm going to press that, and now it's possible to only select skeletal joints. So, let me show you. Let me open up Hypergraph, window, Hypergraph hierarchy. This just shows you a list of all the joints in the scene. And see, I've selected that root joint there, and I'm also going to select those joints underneath it. Now, if I then go to display, and transform display, I'm going to show you what the local rotation axes of each of these joints look like. And a local rotation axis is just, from each bone's point of view, it tells it which direction everything is. So, if you think of this joint down here, this joint number 4, it thinks, from its point of view, the x-axis is pointing straight down this bone. Its y-axis is pointing straight out to the side, to the right here, and its z-axis is pointing straight forward, which means that whenever you ask it to rotate around the x, it's going to spin around this way around the x. If you ask it to rotate around the y, it's going to spin this way around the y-axis. Now, you've noticed the very next one up is completely opposite. This guy thinks its y is going to the right, that one thinks its y is going to the left. This one thinks its z is going straight forward. This one thinks its z is going straight backwards. This is going to cause a problem, because if we go back and select those three joints again, if we then go to the channel box and we select the rotate y parameter there, and if we middle click and drag so that this simultaneously is going to affect every bone at once, you see each bone has its own idea of which way a rotation around the y-axis is. So rather than getting a nice smooth curl when you rotate, when you change all three of those angles at once, you have one curling this way, one curling the opposite way, and the next one curling back again this way, and get this really weird crinkled finger effect, which is not what we want. So I'm going to press Ctrl-Z to undo this. Now, in order to fix this problem, you have to adjust the local rotation axis. So, we're going to want to do this for all three fingers, so let's get them all selected, and going over to Hypergraph, let's make sure we've got those joints blown too. Go display, transform, going to display the local rotation axes, and just kind of toggle those there. Let me... those ones. Window, Okay, now they're all displayed again. Okay, and so we see we see on some of these we have the y-axis going to the left. Let's make them all change so that their y-axes are going to the left. So we're going to click on this to go into component type mode. Then we're going to unselect that because we're not selecting lines. We want to right-click there and select local rotation axes. This will allow us to rotate the local rotation axis. So we're going to zoom in. Let's start with this one over here, and we want to actually we want to rotate that Y around. Actually, subcomponent mode. There we go. And we want to rotate that Y around so it's straight, pointing straight out to the left. So now all of the joints in that finger, when you tell all of them to rotate by around the y-axis, they all have an agreement on which way the y-axis is. It's all going to be going, you know, straight that way, straight forward. And we can do the same thing over here. I'm going to rotate that y around so that it's pointing straight to the left. Same thing for this one on the bottom here. Whoops. Okay, and that looks good. And the baby finger, they're all pointing the wrong direction. So let's just move them all the way over there. It's a little bit too far. Okay. And the next one. Select these things. Just be patient. Okay, that's pointing the right way now. A little bit further. Okay, and one more. Okay, now those y-axes are all pointing the right way. So now, if we go back to the regular selection mode, and we select those joints, and we rotate all the Ys at the same time, now we see those are in harmony. They all bend exactly the same direction when we change the Y. Just gonna press Control Z, going to save that. And okay, so now we've just oriented the joints, and we're let's just double check to make sure that the thumb is all lined up too. Just display. Display. Okay, that's nice and consistent. The Z's are all pointing straight back, the Y's are all pointing to the left. This looks good. Alright, so now that we're happy with the way our skeleton is laid out, the last thing to do is bind the skin to the skeleton. Because you saw before, whenever we moved the skeleton, the skin just stayed where it was. That's because Maya doesn't yet know that the skeleton is supposed to move the skin. So let's do that. Let's first make it possible to select the skin by clicking that button. Select the skin. Gonna shift select the root of the skeleton like that. I'm gonna go skin, bind skin, smooth bind. And now what Maya's done is it's gone through the entire skin, and for every vertex in the mesh, it's found the closest set of bones, the closest two or three bones, and created a weight so that whenever that particular bone moves, the closest vertex moves by a similar amount. So if we select our finger again, and just back to hypergraph and get those other joints as well, and now when we move that finger, wrong way, we see that the entire skin comes along with it. Alright, and that is the basics of setting up your skeleton and binding a skin to it. And next we're going to be looking at rigging, or using controls to help you with rigging, but that's going to be in the next episode.